Hi everybody, Steven here. So you've got NSX or NSX-T all set up and running, but now you need to deploy a load balancer. So you need to deploy the NSX Advance Load Balancer. More specifically, you need to know how to set up the controller cluster. So stick around, that's what I'm gonna cover, and we're gonna do that through the NSX interface. So see you in a bit. Hi everyone, thanks for sticking around. So what I'm gonna do in this video is we're gonna cover how to set up the NSX Advance Load Balancer, AKA the Avi Networks. We're gonna look at how to set up the three node control cluster, and we're gonna do that all within the NSX environment, okay? And I usually like to throw this out at this point. If this is stuff you're interested in, please subscribe to the channel. It does help me out quite a bit. Without subscribers, there's no content developers. So, and for those of you that actually have subscribed to the channel, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. We're almost at that 1,000 target. By the time this is published, hopefully that'll be done. So make sure you subscribe. Let's go into here now. Let me explain what I have in my environment. I actually have my vSphere environment. This is vSphere version 8. You see I've got a Site A cluster, and it's got three nodes, host 1, 2, and 3, and I've got some VMs running on there. The Site A, SA cluster 01, that has been prepared for NSX. So I have NSX all up and running right now. I also have another cluster here. I called it Site A Management Edge Cluster. It's got a yellow mark on it. And you'll see that there's three nodes in there. Again, these are all vSAN clusters, and I've got an edge deployed. So my management slash edge cluster has not been prepared for NSX, and I don't plan on doing it. So I have one cluster for NSX, another one just for management and edge nodes. So when I go into NSX now, you'll see that I basically have, let's go into fabric, let's go into hosts. Under here, you'll see my Site A management edge cluster. It's not been prepared, but the Site A cluster 01 has been prepared. Everything's looking good. I only got one edge node, just trying to save resources. This stuff is pretty resource intensive as well. Most of you probably may know that. So what we need to do now is deploy the appliance. So under system here, I'm gonna go to appliances and give it a few seconds. I only got a single node NSX manager. Again, in production, you should really be running three. Okay, I'm in a lab environment, who cares? I'm gonna go to the NSX Advanced Load Balancer. Now, I've already set up the virtual IP. Before it lets you deploy the appliance, you have to go in here and set the virtual IP. This will be basically the virtual IP that'll be bonded to the leader node of the NSX controller cluster, right? So I've set it up as 172.20.10.74, and then I saved it, okay? So now I'm gonna deploy my individual nodes. So let's deploy our first node. So I'm gonna go add advanced load balancer. Now, over here, this is where you get the opportunity to upload the appliance, okay? So I actually had it locally, so I can upload it, or say remote. I'll say upload, and I can go into here and I can select it locally. I've already done that, okay? Actually, you know what? I guess it's gonna, actually, let me just cancel this. So I would select, actually, let's do it, what the hell? I'll select that, I'll say open, and then I'll say upload. And then you'll see it's like chug, 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 it's going away, uploading it. I'm gonna notice the next button is grayed out until this is uploaded. So let me type in the host name of this first node. So it's gonna be site A-NSX advanced load balancer 01.vclass.local. And I do have forward and reverse lookup set up in my DNS. Again, very important stuff. What's its management IP? It's gonna be 172.20.10.71/24-bit. And the gateway is 172.20.10.10. These are my IP addresses and so on. Yours is gonna vary, right? My DNS server and the NTP server, looks like it's pulled it from NSX Manager, which makes my life a little bit easier. And then what size do I want? Node size says small, medium, or large. I'm gonna pick small. One thing I just realized actually, playing around with this, it looks like they changed the size of small. When we talk about number of virtual CPUs, it's got 8 virtual CPUs as opposed to 6. So I'm not sure what release that got changed in, but be aware of that. So small is 8 virtual CPUs, 24 gigs of memory. Again, nothing to sneeze at here, right? Medium 16 and 32, and large is 24 and 48. And the size is going to be determined by the number of service engines. I talked about it in the first video. That's one metric that you can look at. Okay, so I'm picking small just for the heck of it. So right now it's extracting this controller. We'll give that a few seconds. I may speed this up. Okay, we see that it's uploaded, extracted, is uploaded. Everything's looking good. I'm going to hit the next button. Again, let me just make sure small is still selected. Yep, I'll hit next. Now it's asking me, okay, what compute manager do I want to use to deploy it? I got my vCenter here, Site A vCenter, VCA01. I'm going to use that. It's the only one I got. What cluster do I want to put it on? Again, I would select my management edge cluster or pick whatever appropriate cluster. I'm going to put it on one of the hosts. I think I'm going to put it on host 4. If you've got DRS set up, who cares? So let the cluster figure it out. And what data store? Again, it picked the local data store. It's a vSAN data store on that cluster. And I'll leave the disk format alone. We'll use it, this vSAN storage policy. Now, under network adapter, so it's asking me what port group is your management network on? So I've got a distributed switch for all these, and I got a port group called PG management, and that's where my management is for all my devices. So great, I selected that. I'm going to go next. And at that point, it's asking me for the password for the admin account. And I hit install appliance. And then at this point, it says adding one of three, the appliance will be queued until another appliance is installed. Right, there we go. Okay, so just have to wait a few seconds there. It's now deploying the appliance. This is going to take a little while. I'll probably just speed this up, okay, folks? So it'll probably take about 20 minutes in my environment. So we'll see us back once this is done. Hi everybody, so that we can see that here that my appliance has been deployed. It's 172.20.10.71. We can see that over here. There's my virtual IP. And notice the cluster is degraded. I guess that's because it only has one. It's not a cluster of three, right? So what we can do now is deploy our second and our third. Now, before I do that, let's just try something out. Let's do this. Let's go to PuTTY. I'm going to connect to that NSX Advance Load Balancer. Where are you? Come on. Thought I had that in here. NSX Advance Load Balancer 01. And I'm going to log in as admin. VMware, bang. That's my password. You can probably figure that one out. Let me just change my settings here. For those of you that see me do this stuff, always see me change my settings. Go with the 12, we'll say okay. And I always like to change my background color because, hey, that's just the way I am, right? And okay, and then apply. There we go. So I'm now in, I don't want to say, I'm actually in the bash shell of the appliance. If I want to run the Avi command line CLI, I have to go into the shell. So I kind of wish this was very similar to NSX manager, where I just connect to the NSX manager and away I go. But this one here, I have to type in shell. So hit shell. It's going to ask me to log in again. I'm not going to go too crazy on the command line stuff here. Maybe we'll do a troubleshooting video down the road. Anyhow, I can type in the command show if I want to, and I can hit double tab, and it basically shows me a lot of the options that show command has, right? There's a whole whack load of them there. I want to see the cluster, so show cluster. I'll hit enter. So you'll see here's the cluster name. You'll see there's the IP address of the cluster, 10.74. That's the cluster virtual IP I set. Here's that node's IP address. And you see various information about it. I could type in show cluster status. and we see that it's up. It's no HA. I guess that makes sense because I only got one node. I don't have high availability. If this node goes down, adios, right? So, you know, so that's kind of neat. Let me close that. I'm going to say, okay, I need to deploy my second and third nodes now. Okay. So let's go in, add load balancer. There's my same image. So I'm just going to continue using that. Site A-NSX Advanced Load Balancer-02.vclass.local. And what's the IP? 172.20.10.72/24-bit mask. My gateway is 172.20.10.10. And you see all my DNS and NTP and all that stuff's already filled out. I'm going to deploy the small appliance just to save resources. Again, you have to deploy it depending on the number of service engines and stuff like that, which I talked about in the first video. I'm going to go next. I got my compute manager and NSX already set up. So there's my vCenter server. I'm going to deploy it to my management cluster. Okay. I don't care about resource pools. I'm going to put this one on host 5. And that cluster has a vSAN data store. So I'm going to pick the vSAN data store. And I'll leave the disk format, vSAN, whatever. And then the important one here is the port group. This is my management network, right? So this is... I'm going to put it on a port group on my distributed switch called port group management. That's my management port group on my virtual switch. And I'm done. I click next. Now it asks me for the password. So I'll type in my password and repeat it. And then at that point, I'll say install appliance. Now, notice here. Note, add one or three appliances. Two is not valid. This appliance will be queued until another appliance is installed. So you see it's queued right now. Okay, let's go and add the third one. Let's repeat the process. This will be site A-NSX Advanced Load Balancer-03.vclass.local. And by the way, in case you're wondering, I do have proper forward and reverse lookup set up for these controllers, right? So its address is 172.20.10. This will be 73/24-bit. And the gateway is the same as before. And same DNS and all this. Again, I'm going to deploy the same size. And then I'm going to leave it on my management here. I'm going to deploy this one on host 6. I'll select my vSAN data store on that cluster. And I'll go next. And then pick my management port group. And I'll say OK. So I've got a cluster that's been prepared for NSX. That's like for my overlay networks. I have a separate cluster for my edges and management, okay? That's not been prepared for NSX. That's what I kind of have in my environment here. So this looks good. I can click next. So again, it's asking me for the password. Bang. Bang. And then bang. And then we hit install, and you see controller is now it's installing now. Once I initiated this, it's now doing the install. This is going to take a little while. Let's actually go over to vSphere, see what's going on here. You actually see there's the load balancer 2 and 1 and 2, and then do I get any status here? I should have some kind of thing coming up on the status in vSphere. Probably gonna take a little while. I don't have the quickest environment, okay? This is going to probably take a while. I'll time it and see how long it takes, but I'll just leave this going, and I'll probably speed this up for you folks, okay? And then we'll come back and take a look at it, right? So we'll see you back in a little bit. Okay, we can see that's finally up and running. Took about 20 minutes or so anyways for it to do that. You see the cluster status is now stable. You see I got my three nodes. So let's do a couple things here real quick. Let's go into what we did before. Let's go into PuTTY. And let's go to, I'm going to go to my first node here. And I'll log in as admin. And we'll check it from there and see what it looks like. And let's, while we're waiting for that, let's change the settings. Let's go and increase the font size so you folks can see it better. And I like always to change the colors. Default background, there we go, modify. You know what, Putty, I'd like to make this permanent. If anybody knows, leave comments below. I'll do green. And apply it, there we go. Yeah, maybe not the greatest color, but whatever. Let's just open this up a bit more. So I've logged in. Let's type in shell so we can go into the command line interface. Again, it's going to ask me to log in. I think I typed in the... Got to buy a new keyboard. Some of my keys are sticking, but I've been like that for a year now, so I got to suck it up and get another one. So let's type in show cluster. So we see more information here now. When I showed this before, there was there we go. So we see the cluster information, the cluster IP, the virtual cluster IP. But now we see we got one node here, and it shows the information on the node. Okay. And then over here we see we have a second node. There's my second one I deployed, and then we see we have our third node. All right, so that's kind of cool. Let's look at the cluster status. I'm going to hit enter, and you now see, again, it's up since whatever, and the cluster is up, and HA is now active because I've got three nodes. I will do a video on recovering and failures of nodes and stuff later, but that's about it. Let's do one last thing. Let's connect. There's my cluster IP. Let me connect to my cluster IP here. Let's go into here and type in 172.20.10.74. That's the cluster virtual IP I set, and I'll log in, and it basically comes up and gives me this welcome screen to fix things. It does ask me for a passphrase here. The passphrase is, again, if you're exporting your information or backup, this is kind of what your passphrase is. Let's go through and fill this out. One thing. That's a passphrase, and then I'll just confirm it. Whatever. Your passphrase, you should probably put some thought into that. I'm just pounding in some keys here. My DNS servers, my DNS search domains, they'll be vclass.local, so whatever your domain is. I'm going to hit next. At that point, you set up your email. I'm not going to bother, but in the real world, you would probably set that up. I'm going to click next. And then over here, do you want to do tenancy? I'll probably do a separate video on that. So IP route, per tenant IP route domain, or sharing the routes. I'll do a separate video on that because that can get pretty intense. I'm just going to basically leave the defaults here. Service engines are managed within the tenant or provider. And tenant access, the service engine is read-only and no access. I'll do a separate video because we haven't done videos on service engine and all that stuff. I'll do separate videos on all this. So I'm just going to go with a real quick setup, and I'm going to go save, and then I'm done. So this is what the interface looks like. I'm not going to go through all this stuff right now. I'll have separate videos on it. I'm going to go into, is it administration? I'm going to go into controller, and I'm going to go into nodes. And you actually see by controller cluster, again, it's HA is active. You see the cluster IP that I'd set up, you know, in the beginning, and you see the three nodes, and green is good, and I guess anything else is bad for that, right? So that's kind of nice just from the interface perspective that you can look at the nodes here as well. That's it. So if you found this entertaining or useful, hit that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel and this is stuff you like, please subscribe to the channel. It does me a big favor. If you're without subscribers, there's no content developers, right? So I'm really relying on subscribers. That's it. Thanks again. Leave comments below if there's something you want to see me do here. I always reply back to the comments. And but I am restricted on my resources and stuff like that. But leave comments down below. Let me know what you want to see or do or whatever. That's it. You have a great day, and see you in the next one. Bye now.